this tank, overflow to the last tank.
One bag of these. Yo, done. Sold.
Hell yeah. I'm actually really stoked.
Oh, wow.
Very impressed by your channel. We're very impressed with what you're doing. And what we would love to do is...
All right, so they have exactly what I was looking for. Let me show you guys what it is. I'm sure you know by the title of this video, the thumbnail.
There she is, bro. Look how sick that is. Three bettas in one tank.
Which you guys know, the betta fish at my house. I got her, and then I was like, bro, I want another one.
Betta fish are small, but they are at the same time like super cool fish. Like they got the cool colors. I wanted more with more colors. Now I can have three betta fish in this one little contraption here. I already know I'm getting comments that these are too small, but right there says it's not too small. So I'm gonna go with PetSmart and Petco and any pet stores rules and get this sucker for the betta fish. We've got the filter, one tank, drops down like a waterfall overflow to this tank, overflow to the last tank. And I'm sure there's something under in here that makes it go back up to the first tank. Pretty interesting stuff, but we're gonna do it. We're gonna buy it. It is $50. All right. Guys, like this video right now. Smash the like button, like this video, and I'll buy it if you like the video. I'll wait a second real quick. Perfect. Compact design is perfect to use on desktops at work and home office. Home office, going in.
I have a plant from the world's smallest aquarium video, if that was my last video. But I have a plant from there, so we don't really need any more plants. We just need some rocks. And maybe like another kind of decorated rock, like this. It's only a dollar. We're definitely doing that right there. Top black river rock top fin, $1.99. These are like bigger black rocks right here. And these will make it look really nice. And then, like I said, we're gonna go with white rocks. So we'll grab one bag of these. Should, honestly, like should fill it up. Like, I don't see why that would not fill it up. Can you, oh my God. Our white rocks and then our triple betta fish tank right there. We are set. It's looking to be probably around $65. All right, we have all the items we need. I'm just gonna get some live plants because just, you know, why not? The Amazon sword. These are the ones I've always liked the most. This Amazon sword right here, we'll get one of these. Java fern. One of these two, right? Oh, it looks pretty dope. No. Like I wanna get like, oh bro, that's so cool. And I'll get this guy right here. So I'll get these two plants right here. All right, now that I've thought about it, I really don't want these live plants. I'm gonna put them exactly where they were. Right there, and right there. And we're gonna come over here. Those are $5 a piece. We're trying to keep it on a budget here. We're gonna go with the $119 for artificial, because the one I have at home is artificial, so why not make them all artificial? So we're gonna stick with this guy right here, and then this one looks pretty solid. This guy right here. So that's $2.20 for two of them that look kind of just like the same. So we got these instead right there. Look at that. All right, I've got to get something like this. Like I have to get like one of these guys or something that you guys can name inside the betta fish tank. It just needs to happen. So I believe I'm really liking this guy. Like Alfredo could be his name or something. These dogs will actually be quiet so I could film. Yo, done. Sold. Guys.
Oh my God.
The gold turtle. What's his name? What is his name?
Name this guy right here. He's going in the betta fish tank. In one of them. Probably the middle one or the last one. I don't know yet. We'll see when we set it up. Name him. What's his name? We got Fred, Larry, Jim, Jimbo. All sorts of names. Just throw a name down below and I'll pick you and I'll put you in one of these upcoming videos. Just like I always do.
God, dude, I gotta get out of here. I keep spending more money. Anyway, look at that, guys. We are set. We're like loaded down pat. Betta fish tanks.
Look at this.
Buddy's shopping too. I really would feel comfortable if I got another bag of these. So I'm gonna get another bag of these. I'm just kidding, you're good, bro. I need a cart. Cause I can't get all this there. Look, that's literally microscopic. Like not even the size of my hand, the fish lives in that. The golden turtle, not sure what his name is, but he is legendary. So he's going in first and he's gonna be on the seat. One bag of rocks, two bags of rocks, more rocks, one plant, two plant, the tank. We are officially all set, ready to go. Let's head home and set this thing up. And just like that, we are home. There's Luna. I kind of made a space to put this tank right here. As you can see, it's like a round shape. So I made a space that we can kind of put it right here. It'll look real good right in that corner. This is pretty much how it's going to look. We're going to push this up in that corner. And then we'll have the betta fish line right there. Four betta fish in total right there. We're gonna have to go get the other three for this later on one of these videos, probably the next video actually. Now unfortunately it is 11:10 p.m. right now, so no one is awake in this house besides me. So you're just gonna be on a tripod and I'll try to film this pretty much as best as I can.
Ooh.
Shimmy, 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 shimmy. Oh, that thing is sick. Alrighty, no need for this anymore. Now, I thought personally that these tanks right here, you can see Luna swimming around right there, were a lot smaller than this. Now, they're small, but they're definitely bigger than I thought. And I'm actually pretty stoked about that. But here is the final thing right here. This is just gonna, oh, cool. Comes with a betta fish food discount right there. So I still haven't taken the plastic off yet. I thought it was a little bit bigger. Anyway, we have it right here, just like that. As you can see, the overflows is gonna flow down like this. I'll move Luna over once we're done. And all these betta fish will be in one row right here. So when I'm editing, and of course I'll come back and do updates on these guys as well and film them. I have no idea what kind of colors, pretty much anything, females, males. I'm not exactly sure what we're gonna do with this. That'll be cool in the next video. You can see the overflows. It's actually really, really cool. Got like a spillway overflow. Let's take this plastic off and get a better look at it. We got water conditioner, like dechlorinator right here. This is just a sample size. Obviously it should work for all this, even though I do have some more betta safe right here. So we are set on that. Man, dude, they are hooking you up right here. Now we got some betta food as well. That's the second layer, third layer. First thing I see here is remove before use. As you can see on the directions, there's a tiny nozzle which is in the filter inside there that you can actually twist to measure how much water you want to flow throughout the tank. I'm just gonna leave it on how it is and see how that is, and hopefully we won't even notice the difference. Shout out to my grandma for painting that picture right now. I know she's watching this. Thank you, that thing is dope. I always tell you guys these things that twist on all the wires to keep them neat, leave them on there, or if you need more, then just take it out to where you need it, so unravel it. Pull it out to where you need it, say you need one more, do that, and then twist it back exactly like that and put it back on just so everything is neat. I'm gonna pop this off right here, get it ready to be plugged into the first overflow is set in position. We're gonna get number two, which is right here. You just kind of come up under it and then put it in spot. Bam, there's number two. Now I'm gonna do the same exact thing for this one. Come up under it and slide it into place. There is number three. Dude, check it. That is sick. Hell yeah. I'm actually really stoked to see how this thing runs when it is completely done. Now, that is when we swing on over to, wow, there's lots of trash in the ground. This whole bag of junk right here, actually not junk, it's actually amazing. These rocks that will come in handy in just a second. Another plant. And the rocks. These are what we need right now. These two guys right here. Right, let's get these rocks into the aquarium so that we can get this water going, running, and be ready for a betta fish. And I could obviously add more, but look how much I have left of one bag. It's still literally more than half the bag, and I still have an extra. Should not have bought two, but hey, you never can go wrong. This right yonder is where it's gonna get nice looking. These guys are gonna kinda make that white pop. We're adding the big rocks in with the white rocks right now to really make those white rocks stand out. What we're gonna do is kinda make like the little ledges, and we'll obviously use as many black rocks as we can. For now, we're gonna keep on doing something just like that. Alrighty, now you got a view from all three of those little sections filled with the black rocks. Remember when I was talking about how we made that tiniest aquarium in the world? Yeah, this was the aquarium. Anyway, this is the plant from that video. So, we got our three plants. That's, I think, how it's gonna go right there. There it is. It's almost like the plant is kind of buried up behind those black rocks, which I think is pretty sick. We're gonna bury this guy just like that right there. So there's the second one. Now, as you can see, we've got two of them done. There's one, there's two. It'll look a lot better when there's water, and of course, when there's a betta fish in it. Now the last plant, this is pretty dope. I like this one, it's got like the curls in it. Push that rock like that. Throw this stone on top of there. That's pretty much how I'm gonna end it, just like that. So we are pretty much set with all three aquariums. Get this thing running here in just a second. I've got one plug open, as you can see, right here, ready to go in. And we're gonna push this up like this and then move Luna. Oh, sorry, Luna. Just like that. So there'll be Luna, which has a filter and a light on it, with all three of these. Right now we've gotta add some water so that we are ready to get some fish when we go to Petco or whatever. Oh, wow, oh, that's solid, wow. All right,
I'm plugging.
PC merch. Good Lord. Thank God for the PC merch. Saving the day once again. Yeah, you'll have to change this every once in a while. I just actually changed Luna's water. Just cleaned her tank right before I made this video. So she is all set. When I was moving her over to here, I cleaned the tank in the process, so. Luna's all happy and clean. Not good. Name this golden turtle. We're about to put him in. He is a legend, as you can see. Fully solid gold. Probably like $7,000. No, I'm kidding. He's like $4. So there's the golden turtle in the center aquarium right there. Coming up fast, too. Damn. There it goes. Straight down. Down into that one. Now it is probably going to get down into that one in here in just a second. She's filling up. It's filling up, there it goes, down into that one. You can see the waterfall going on the back side of that right there, the overflow. There's the waterfall behind it, which is releasing the water back into the bottom of the aquarium, then circulating it back down these three layers. This thing came out insane. Golly. Right here is the final product, right next to Luna. Here we go. I'm actually pretty stoked to get three of these betta fish. It's gonna look like a little waterfall down into Luna's tank, pretty much, because Luna's right here. But here's the three new additions that we're gonna be picking up here in just a few on this channel. Don't miss that video. Hit the subscribe button, guys. Join the family, become a Cuffaro. We just hit 100K and we were just blowing past that milestone. So let's keep it going, Cuffaros. Thank you for watching. Here's the tank that I bought for this, $75. You can have this whole entire setup yourself. We're gonna get some betta fish. Also, before I end this video just yet, we had visitor come yesterday, and super stoked to what they offered me, so here's those clips.
Hey,
what's up, guys?
The man, the myth, the legend himself. How you doing, buddy?
Nice to meet you. Yeah. Nice to meet you, guys.
This is Ed Ballou.
Nice to meet you.
This is Chris.
Nice to meet you, man.
Okay.
You got someone over here, too?
And this is Brian ordering coffee for the Uber driver to bring back to him.
Oh, gosh. He needs some coffee.
Yeah, buddy. Listen, we've been on the road for 10 days, and we have 10 water features in 10 days.
Yep.
So actually, this is the 10th day. So 10 water features in 9 days. We're on our way home, so we swang by here, going to the airport.
Thanks, sir.
And we didn't even realize that you were here. I've been following your channel.
Yeah.
Until last night.
Ryan.
We met, who's that guy?
Ryan Nitz.
Ryan, he's a snook fisherman.
Yeah. Yeah, he called me and he's like, hey, I got some guys that
this
only
is thing. Brian. Hey, how's it going?
How's it going, man?
Nice to meet you. Are you subscribed?
I am, yeah.
All right.
I am, yes.
So Brian's been with me for 23 years.
How old are you?
17.
17. Yeah. I started 18.
Oh, 18. Year after. It was cool. The main reason I got into doing it is because I loved fishing.
That's all I did.
The idea of keeping my own pet bass and
I got
baby northern pike and stuff.
And we can head back there and we can check out the pond.
Yeah. Hey, it looks just like it did on the vlog channel. Exactly. You got a blooming lily already.
Yeah.
The night bloomer.
Yeah, it is.
Yes.
Nice. Actually, really clear now. Cleared up. You can see the bass right there.
Oh, sweet. Holy cow.
Brian's going to be jealous.
That's a big fish, man. That's a huge bass.
That's a big bass.
See him come right out to my finger?
Come on, we got to find
He's
a lizard.
He's literally sitting right there. Oh, we got to. I mean, we could definitely get one if you head to the park. Park that's down there.
Here's what I'm gonna say. This pond is 100 times better than my first pond.
Yeah, this is the first one. I mean, I built others. I built one right here, like kind of at an angle like that. And then I was like, it's not big enough. Then I built another one that was kind of too shallow. So then I built this one. And this one.
We saw deep, you. I watched you. There. I watched all the mistakes you made.
Yeah, it was deep enough. And then
so now we'll just take everything out and we'll just make the whole back there pond.
Back
and your mom's a cool lady, right?
Yeah, she's cool. She'll let us do that.
So good. What does your mom and dad think?
They honestly don't like it when I'm in the making of it. And the second, like, cause there's dirt everywhere and they don't know what it's gonna look like. And the second I finish, they love it.
You know what? You just got cool parents if they're, you know, they're gonna let you do this. I was 12 years old when I built my first pond. Uh-huh. I moved from New Jersey to, I brought 11 of my pet turtles with me. And my mom promised me that I could build a pond, and then I started digging the hole and she freaked out.
Yeah.
Because she thought it was too big.
That's how it was when I built this one. She was like, how big, because I came all the way out to here.
Right.
And if you see in the video when I made it, it just looks so different than this right here. So when I dug it, she was like freaking out, like, I don't like how this looks. And she's like, I was throwing dirt right here. There's a pile of dirt like this high.
Did you haul all the dirt away?
I ended up just flattening out. We're going to get sawed. Yeah.
Okay.
And then we're going to get sawed to go
over. No, we don't need sod. We're going to make this all water.
Yeah, you can do that too. Sure.
No, very good. So, Brian, you are 100% correct. This is better than any of our first ponds.
Yeah, like
my first pond was concrete. It leaked, turned green, and my prized turtles migrated away. So, and Brian had game fish just like this. He used to hold the worms up, and they would jump 3 feet out of the water to get them.
If we got a lizard, the second that thing hit the water, he would eat it. I wish I could. I don't know if it's just they usually don't come out when it's cold like this. Right. We got a little live blow right here. This has just got a little filter in it with a heater.
Yeah.
And I just put bass in it. And you're pretty much stuffed in there. And then
it
makes you
run
in. Yep. And he destroys it. As you can see, he follows you.
Yeah, that's awesome.
If I'm over here and I just shake and see him.
Yep, he turns. See? So we gotta get a lizard. So let's go get a lizard for this guy.
Sure, we can try to find him. I see the little
guy. Oh, wait, there he is.
There he is, He's on your pants.
Got him. Okay.
All right, so that's two. There's a baby one right here. I mean, we could try to get him. I think he's a little too small. It's like four babies.
We got two of them. We should be good,
yeah,
right?
That's fine.
Yeah.
Okay. There we go. Easiest spots to catch lizards under trash cans. Always produces some lizards.
Yeah.
I catch them every time I come here.
So how often do you feed them?
Depends. So if I went about a week ago and I got a shad, like gizzard shad, like this big.
Yeah.
It's probably almost the size of the bass. But he's skinny, so I threw him in the second I threw him in, he got them.
Wow.
Without like a second hesitant, just the second it came out of my hand, just ate the whole thing.
Whoa! Holy cow.
There he comes. Ready?
Oh! Wow.
That was awesome.
So it's without hesitant. He just hops right onto that lizard.
So, like I was saying, Brian, 23 years, Chris, 5 years, we had our own TV show on Nat Geo Wild called Pond Stars.
Mm-hmm.
We're very impressed by your channel. We're very impressed with what you're doing. And what we would love to do is show you what we've developed over 27 years in this business. We really basically were the pioneers back in the day when there was no major equipment.
Mm-hmm.
And to this day, we're the only manufacturer of pond equipment that builds ponds.
Yep.
So we've just got on a marathon journey of not 10 water features in the last 9 days. We're flying home, but we wanted to stop by and see you because what we would love to do is have you come up to Chicago for the Aquascape Hands-On Academy.
Mm-hmm.
It's a 2-day course where you get to work in the sand pit with Brian, with Chris, working right alongside building water features and designing water features. And then we tell you basically how we've done everything that Aquascape does to design, build, and retail water features. And then we would love to have you come and present about what you're doing with your YouTube channel at the largest gathering in the world of pond professionals called Pondemonium in August, because we need more kids like you that are passionate about being outside in nature and doing things. So we want to encourage other guys just like you to be able to show their passion and their hobby. So for us, it would be an honor to have you come and speak to all of our contractors and retailers in Chicago in August. And before we get there, it would be fantastic and a lot of fun to have you come work alongside of us in our indoor sand pit, learning and designing some advanced water feature techniques.
For sure, I'm so down for that.
Yeah. That's awesome. All right, you deserve it, buddy. Yes, yes.
That'd be awesome. Learn a lot from that.
So the next time we'll be seeing you on camera is going to be in Chicago at Aqualand, which is our state-of-the-art green facility that was built in 2005. And it's got water feature galore. It's heaven. It is a pond guy's heaven.
Mm-hmm.
So welcome to heaven, kid.
Until next time, I'll see you in the next video. Peace. I'm gonna put this in my betta fish tank.